全民来公审，人民是头家，欢迎收看《全民公审》。今天这一集是特别企划制作《全球公审》。从西元1986年开始，联合国订定每年的12月2号是废除奴隶制国际日，提醒人民要消除现代形式的奴隶制问题。现在在世界上，其实大部分的地区都不允许对人身自由的限制控制，但是根据劳工组织的统计。全世界现在有4000多万人是沦为现代奴隶制的受害者，就是因为遭受胁迫、暴力、欺骗或是滥用权力等等，导致被剥夺的处境。那其实这些手段啊，它的来源有多数，竟然是来自政府用不正常的手段行使公权力造成的哦。那甚至在台湾就有一件这样子人权迫害的案件是被提交到联合国。首先邀请我们的来宾 Damon 跟我们分享。
因为我工作的性质，我很常要去欧美啊，甚至亚洲各个国家。我其实的确有发现一件事情，就是欧美地区啊，甚至像印度啊，各个国家，我觉得有个特色是他们很会努力的去争取自己的权益，他们都是非常勇于的提出自己的想法跟愿意去争取。台湾人相较于其他国家是比较安静的。虽然说近几年台湾的社会运动的确相较于几年前真的是比较兴盛，可是我也发现到说，针对自己的权益受损的时候，其实普遍的人还是不会勇敢的站出来去争取自己的权益。在现在这个新时代，这个民主社会、民主法治的时代，其实真的有不公不义或是自己权益被侵犯的时候，其实都应该要主动站出来发声。因为现在的时代反而会变成你不主动出来争取自己的权益，你反而就是默认了那些去侵害你权益的那些人或是政府机关，反而对自由民主法治是一种伤害。
The Tai Jinping case is a case of freedom of religion or belief form, which we can divide in four times. Time one, and in 1996,religious and spiritual groups suspected of not supporting the president were severely repressed. Tai Jinping was also involved in this, even if it never took political sides. Its grandmaster or shifu, Dr. Hong, was arrested and members were persecuted.Second time, the total victory of Tai Jinping up to the highest courts in Taiwan. Tai Jinping won all the court cases. Dr. Hong and his co-defendants were declared innocent and even awarded compensation money for the past unjust detention. Time number three, however,a byproduct of this form persecution remain in the shape of tax bills. Even if the courts had said there was no tax evasion, the tax bureau continued to try to impose bills on Dr. Hong and Tai Jinping.The tax bureau revoked all the bills except one for the year 1992 based on a technicality. And time number four, even if courts of law told them not to do it, the tax bureau and the enforcement agency in 2020, auctioned and then confiscated the lands belonging to Dr. Hong.And intended for a spiritual cultivation center of Tai Jinping.
The followers of Tai Jinping have learned in the hard way an important thing. If they didn't fight themselves for their rights, nobody would do it for them. And they courageously did it. They did it very courageously, I must say. Some were not even bornwhen the case started, and others died in the meantime. And in the case of Taiwan, the state has crossed the red line. It has crossed the red line, and this has had tragic consequences, because in such cases, when the state interferes in the private sphere and in the autonomy of a religious group, it's not only disputable, but it's always very bad, as Marco stressed. For almost 25 years, Taiji Man has been fighting against a number of evil forces and has chosen not to compromise with them. It would have been easy to pay a modest fine and hereby get rid of a burdensome and never-ending judicial battle. The Taiji Man has refused to follow the apparently easy road and has chosen to follow its conscience. Taiji Man's battle is not only for Taiji Man and his disease. It is a battle for the well-being of all the Taiwanese.
Well, no country is perfect. But the problem is that when it's a so-called democratic country, which starts erring on the wrong side of the tracks, when injustice occurs in a place that is supposed to be one of the good places of the world, the effect may be worse than when it occurs in an already totalitarian country. Why? Because it lowers the very standards of democracy for the entire world. In the Taiji Man case, the authority of control has found gross violations of human rights by the authorities for their wrongful handling of the case. That is already a good thing, but it has not stopped the fanatics who were at the origin of all attacks against the Taiji Man. It has not put a final period to the case, because what matters to Taiji Man disease is not the property per se. What matters the most is their right to practice their spirituality freely without being harassed.
So in 1996, I was a college student majoring in French. On December 19, the press started to report a raid on Taiji Man by Investigation Bureau. My father was detained 4 months without any evidences of crime. I started to feel scared as father was not with us. Many years later, we realized mother tried to hide a lot of things from the protection of me and my sister. She was under a lot of pressure from my uncles who read the biased reporting in the paper. They thought my father was a disgrace to the family. My father was held in custody for months just because he did not yield to the intimidation from prosecutor Ho and insisted that Dr. Hong has real kung fu. And my father received state compensation for wrongful detention after 10 years. But tax office continued to ignore evidences from Taiji Man. Tax office and enforcement agency worked together to auction off properties of Taiji Man in the past August. My father did not want us to be worried, so he really discussed Taiji Man case with us. He passed away in 2014, and he never got a chance to see prevail. Justice prevail in Taiji Man case.
To stay far away from the nightmare caused by prosecutor Ho Kuan-ren, I have moved to the United States for almost 18 years. On Christmas Eve in 1996, there was no peace in my family. Even though no one accused my dad of any crime, he was detained and not allowed to communicate with others by the prosecutor for 4 months. Our house was searched by means of hunger, fatigue, and threat. The prosecutor just wanted my dad to testify against my shifu. My dad was the chief financial officer of a famous company with outstanding credit. However, because of prosecutor's illegal investigation, his credit was totally ruined. 2 or 3 days after my dad was released on bail, the bank withdrew our mortgage. It was impossible for my parents to make ends meet only on my mom's salary. Afterwards, because of negative and false press reports, my mom, who worked in the Ministry of Justice, was under a lot of pressure and was forced to retire early. My sister and I went abroad. to leave the heartbreaking place. She went to France, and I came to the United States. Years later, my dad received national compensation for unlawful imprisonment. But nothing could ever compensate for our pain and suffering from this incident.
In Tai Chi Men, I learned how to keep myself healthy, and I can also learn mindful Kung Fu and gain positive energy. Our Sifu in Tai Chi Men constantly teaches us the highest philosophical thoughts of mankind so that we understand true cultivation, reflect on ourselves every day, and practice Tai Chi Men Qigong to stabilize my mood so I know how to cherish the people around me, and I'm more and more capable of speaking and doing nice things. I find love and peace in Tai Chi Men. Tai Chi Men is a martial art and Qigong Menpai similar to the school that cultivates the soul and heart to save ourselves and others. When my relatives and friends see my happiness and youthfulness, they also want to be happy like me. However, the Tai Chi Men's fabricated case occurred on December 19, 1996, when a prosecutor's false prosecution caused many media in Taiwan to publish false news reports. Many of my friends and relatives did not even dare to come to Tai Chi Men to cultivate themselves, and some of them were not well conditioned physically and mentally. A good friend of mine wants to be as happy as I am, but the news of the fake Tai Chi Men case made her afraid of coming to Tai Chi Men. Unfortunately, she chose to take her life at such a young age. I'm really sad and sorry for this stage. Many countries are suffering from severe epidemics, natural and man-made disasters, unrest in the world, government corruption, killing people, and persecuting human rights, etc. I am blessed to awaken my conscience every day and use the internet and various social medias to spread online information, activities, and Sifu Dr. Hong's speeches to promote the International Day of Conscience. I am willing to awaken the conscience of the world and promote world peace so that we can return to a peaceful world.